Hey, testing 1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2, 3. The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plains. The ants in your pants move to France. Hey, it's a double coffee day. Gonna need it. Hey, let me remind you that trading's risky, not appropriate for everyone. Your past performance, good or bad, it's not necessarily indicative of future results. Stay small, stay humble, focus on the long term, and never risk money you cannot afford to lose. Look at that. Born to trade. Oh, really? Really? Do I look tired? Oh, my God. I don't know what it is, huh? This age, I just poof up. Gee whiz. Oops. I know what I needed to do. Sorry. Hello. My name is Wayne McDonell. I'm the Chief FX Market Strategist for TradersWay.com. Throw your diamond in the sky. I just realized I'm wearing Ritz-Carlton clothes. I have a Ritz-Carlton Dubai hat and a Hong Kong shirt. Whoops. Yeah, didn't mean that. So anyways, I do these sessions 7:30 in the morning, Monday through Friday here at Forex.Today. So for non-farm payrolls, I do that with FX Street. Been trading currencies for, I don't know, 15 years, been doing webinars for about 12 or 13 years. Nice to meet you. Two diamonds in the sky, Trader's Way. Thank you so much for being a client. We appreciate you. And if you are new to these sessions, I would like to earn your loyalty and respect. And hopefully you open up a trading account with our firm. We'll treat you with kindness. We want you to succeed, and that's my mission. My mission statement is, I want you to succeed. So good morning. Yeah, Joe says it's not, it is Full Metal Jacket. This goes back, I did this like 13 or 14 years ago. And it is from the poster, so I don't know if that gets me in the hot water. But they changed it. I had a really good design team. They changed it from Born to Kill to Born to Trade. They put the FX Bootcamp star on it and then the logo. It was the coolest thing. So I had like the mouse pad and the all kinds, it was really well done. And my design team was run by a guy that ran the Stanford web design lab as an undergrad. Worked for me for about a year or so and went to Harvard. I'm like, who goes to Harvard? Really? Such a ponytail liberal. All right, so I'm super tired. I don't know if you caught that. I've only slept a couple hours, whatever, blah, 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 blah. Oh, it's so hard being a currency trader. So anyways, let's just get going. And if I start babbling, I just want you to know that that's what's going on. Okay, going back to EuroCAD, this goes from non-farm payrolls. Oh, Sha says, hey, good morning, Wayne. Good morning, Sha. Side question. What is a good gauge to place a stop loss to avoid stop? Whoa, okay. Wow. Premature stopping, huh? Well, Sha, it always has to go back to what your trade plan was and what type of strategy. Obviously, if I'm scalping, my stop placement's going to be different than if I'm in a position trade. Okay? And a position will be different from a swing. And then, of course, is it a monthly swing? Is it a weekly swing? Is it a spot trade? All these things are going to change. So, for example, let's pretend this is a 1 minute chart. Oh, it is a 1 minute chart. Okay, this is a 1 minute chart. Let's say your plan was to sell around here. Okay, knowing that it'll fall there or it'll fall there, it doesn't really matter. Or maybe you want to fib it. So you draw a fib and you know it should be about the sweet spot. So your general plan is to let it rise a little bit and then to sell. Okay? So your finger's on the trigger. Where would you put your stop, Shaw? Above resistance, yeah. So let's just say, let's say your plan is to sell here. So let's say now we'll use this as a stop. So let's say your stop should be about there. Would you agree? And maybe if you want to be ultra conservative, you would put it up here. Okay? Cool. Great. Fine. Now imagine we had that same trade plan, but instead of 1 minute candles, these were 4 hour candles. So now you're looking at 4 hour chart. Let's say it's exactly the same, but it's 4 hour candles now. Would you put your stop in a different place now? Or would it be exactly the same stop placement? Thank you, Carol. I'm glad you like the book. What if you want to sell at the 21? Okay, then basically you treat it like a 382. That's fine. There's other ways of dealing with it, but let's you, right? No, it should be around the same place, guys. Okay, it should be around the same place. But if it's a 4 hour chart, we might be talking 250 pips or 300 pips. We're talking about a 1 minute chart, we might be talking about 30 pips. Okay? So one of the evils that new traders run into is that you guys get out of trades too quick and you lose a lot. Death by a thousand lashes. So one way to work on that is to avoid scalping, because it breeds bad habits, especially if you're scalping and you don't know how to trade. So now you're taking bad habits and then you're teaching yourself, right, more and more and more. By the way, look at that trade, huh? Boom, boom, boom. So your stop should be in there and you should stay in until things have technically changed. Okay? So you have to ask yourself, if you sold, obviously you were a bear, when is it no longer bearish, technically speaking? That's when I want you to get out. Not when you're losing money, when it's no longer technically bearish. And you're not allowed to add to new positions until you're profitable. So your first trade, especially if it's a mediocre entry, you might sit on it for an hour or two before you get an opportunity to add to it. Or if it's a losing trade and with a mediocre entry in a mediocre direction, you could be in it for hours before you get knocked out for a loss. But what we want to start avoiding is quick losses. Okay. Yeah, sure. Just again, I think the deep message is trade technically, and that is using stop management as well. If you're selling, then by definition, the market should be bearish. And if it's bearish, that means it's trending down. So if you sold at resistance, then you should be fine. And if it makes a higher high, stop shorting. You don't want to get caught in the other stuff, lots and lots of little trades, because you're going to find that you will die of 1,000 lashes. Okay? Well, it's not over trading. That's what a lot of people call it. It's just poor trading. You know, I think if you were running a multi-billion dollar hedge fund, you would only pull the trigger if you knew you would make money. You know what I mean? And that's how derivatives are really designed, when you start combining options and futures and all these different things along with the underlying asset classes. You trade and you know how much money you're going to make when you pull the trigger. And if things go wrong, you know, you'll still make money, or you'll protect your downside, right? You keep your powder dry, so to speak. But like, it's not a gamble. Do you think that the guys at the top are like really gambling? Right? Oh, well, I only lost $300 million, but it was just fun. We were trying. We were scalping, right? No. Right? So you need to treat it like that. So this is why I go through a methodology, sort of a loose methodology. I don't even know if methodology is the right word, but I think newer traders like mechanical systems, like do this, do this, do this, do this, right? Checklist, checklist, checklist. So, is the market bullish or bearish? Well, actually, I should step back. Are you bullish or bearish? Okay? That's called strategy. So, Carol bought my book, right? Strategic and Tactical Forex Trading. What's your strategy? Are you a bull or a bear? And, of course, fundamentally speaking, you should be able to back that up with logic and intelligence, right? And you could do this speech today, tomorrow, next week. You can go to a Forex Trading Expo, stand on stage in front of hundreds and hundreds of people and say, I'm a bear because of blah, 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 blah. And everyone would applaud. I mean, I did that for years. Okay? Great. So now that you're established that you're a bull or a bear, does the market agree? Is it trending up or is it trending down? Then, when you get the favorable market conditions, now, tactically, you can start developing an entry and an exit plan. Okay? Is it making a series of lower lows and lower highs? Yes or no? Yes. Great. And you're a bear, right? Yes. And the market's bearish, right? Yes. Fantastic. Where's resistance? Right? And that's when you start putting together trade plans and stuff like that. But, you know, we know that most traders don't do it that way. It's like playing a video game. And they're just down throwing around trades. And then they tell me, Wayne, I want to be a professional. I want to manage other people's money. I want to drive a Ferrari. What do I need to do? Boo, 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 trade, trade, trade. They're like, right, like dogs. Squirrel! Whoa! Whoa, that was a Eurocad scalp right there. Whoa. So as I was saying, trade, trade. Oh, I missed it. It just came and went. Whoa. I'm missing it. I'm missing it. I got to trade. Right? No. So you need to start pretending at least that you have a strategy and a bias and an opinion. Like I said, like these central banking news events, even if you don't know what it is, just download the reports and read them. Just pretend you're a professional. Isn't that what I actually say in my book? Just fake it till you make it. Just download these central banking reports, because one day you want to be the type of money manager that actually reads and understands these reports. And here, all you're doing is building the proper behavior and habits for your future success. You don't want to say, oh, one day I'm going to download these reports and understand them. Just download and read them now. Okay? Carol says, how do you know if the trend has changed or if the trend is just retracing? Okay, great. Fib question. Beep. Okay, here's the sweet spot. 382 to 618 Fibonacci retracement. As you can see, this is a 382. As you can see, I did this after non-farm payrolls. And after non-farm payrolls, I said oil would go up. And I already have the trade plan set at the 382, and that predicts a 1618, which is about here. Good. Like magic, it happened. Okay. 382. Aggressive. 50%. Middle sweet spot. 618, conservative, but also bullish. 786, whoa, cautious. Expect the potential for a double top or a wimpy little high like a 121.4. Anything more than a 786 retracement. So now we're talking, like, if I'm going to draw this, now we're talking about, oh, look at that. Wow, I've never done that before. Cool. Now we're talking this. If you get 100% retracement, remember, this is 382, right? 38% retracement, 50% retracement, 62% retracement, 79% retracement, and down here is 100% retracement. 100% retracement is no longer a retracement. It's a reversal. Anything more than that, it's a retracement. And this comes from the principles of price action. So let's do this. Okay. The principles of price action. The principles of price. If it's trending higher and it's aggressive, it'll make a small retracement and a large extension. Okay? If it's slowing down, it'll make more of a retracement and make less of an extension. And if it retraces quite a bit, it is cooling off significantly, and you should expect a change in the direction. Like a lack of capability to make a higher high, which would then put you in a consolidative mode, which then would cool things off, which would then make a lower low, which then brings it back for a retracement, new trend, bit of a cool off, so on and so forth. Okay, you see what's happening? 382, 618, 786. Trap it in consolidation. Okay. Roll reversal. Break it, right? So breakout, retracement, expansion. Right? This And then this gave us a small retracement, small and new consolidation or whatever. Yeah, and this is an old man easing into a hot bath. That's correct. This is market expanding, consolidating, and reversing. Okay. And these were not little random things I drew. I mean, this is a very specific thing. Okay. So you know if you are in here, okay. So let's say you're a bull. It expanded, retraced, you grabbed a 382. Great. You're excited, the market's bullish and aggressive. Okay, it comes up to the next level of resistance, drops, makes about a 50% to a 618. Great, you're still aggressive because you're higher than this high. Great. So you buy a second one. Great. Everything's wonderful. Great. Uh-oh, a 786? You barely survived. Your stop barely survived, right? Because you got this stop here, which you've now moved here, so that you have this times two. Almost got knocked out and rallied back up, but you know a 786 predicts a double top. So when you're at the double top, if you added a third, you get out of here for 3x, three trades. And you're expecting consolidation, which means you stop using moving averages and you start using oscillators at support and resistance. At some point, it breaks out. You don't know if it's going to break up or down, nor do you care. But you do observe this breakout, and you're expecting a retracement back to the roll reversal, which is this old area here, which you're only selling down and then rinse and repeat using price action. Right? Then you move your stop from there to here, and then your second trade and there to move it to here, and then your third trade and here, and now you're up for 3x. Three trades. Three trades long, three trades short, 9 days old. Yeah. My pleasure, Peter. You can send cigars if you want. All right. And by the way, I think in the last entire year, four people have actually sent me cigars. The interesting thing is three are named Pete or Peter. Isn't that interesting? Pete's and Peters are great people. That's why they name him Peter the Great. Pete the Great. In your example, if someone asked you if you're a bull or a bear, what would your response be? In my, yeah, in the role reversal stuff, in the old man thing, see, your answer to whether you're a bull or a bear, because I'm assuming like that was a shorter time frame from a 1 minute to a 15 minute to an hour, nothing more. But you wouldn't be a bull or a bear necessarily just on an hourly chart. So the answer to whether you're a bull or bear comes from long-term technical analysis, but preferably fundamental analysis. Right? And we used Brian as an example yesterday. I said, hey, when I told Brian about whatever report it was, Beige Book, right? I'm like, hey, Ryan, you should read the Beige Book. He's like, I'm going to read the Beige Book. Like, you should read this. It's really helpful information. It's all about the Fed. I'm going to read the Beige Book. And Bobby's reading the Beige Book, right? It's the same sort of thing, like, you should take an economics class. I'm going to take an economics class, right? You should just do it. Look, I'm 44 and I'm in an economics class now. Look, what's on the desk of a currency trader? A $400 economics book. And look, you know I know this stuff. I teach it. But it doesn't matter. Maybe I can get a little bit smarter. Look, it's unbelievably heavy. Right? Look at this garbage. So what do you do in your spare time? Right? Besides reading newspapers, it's barons. Just stuff laying around. Yeah. That's funny. There's a Cuban cigar over there. You know, I'm your guide and your mentor. And if you want to be a success, you have to realize that I'm a peon, right? I'm a nobody. I'm just a small speculative trader, right? But I'm your competition in a way. Like, I mean, I'm not trading against you, but just imagine that. What if I represented the other person on the other side of the trade? Every time you pull the trigger, like, you know, what would Wayne do, right, kind of thing? And you can almost use it, because, like, what I did this for myself, and this is why I'm using this example, and I don't know if I'm making sense because I haven't slept much, but in the book I do talk about how I had no mentors, I didn't know a currency trader, there weren't currency traders around. I mean, there was no books, no forums. You had to be a banker, right? So I invented a mentor. I called him the perfect trader. Oh, I look terrible. I called him the perfect trader, and I wrote down characteristics that this person, this mythical unicorn, would have as a trader. And then I just tried to mimic that unicorn trader, that perfect trader. And I did things like, I need a book on foreign exchange. So I went to Amazon. At the time, Amazon was still a small company. I think it only really sold books at the time. Can you imagine how long ago this was? And so I Googled Forex, and the only thing that came up was Forex Made Easy. So I sat back, and I'm like, where can I find a book on banking and foreign exchange? I know. I will drive to Stanford University and look at the textbooks they offer their students in banking, finance, and hopefully I'll find something specifically on foreign exchange. And that's kind of like where I started, right? And so anyways, well, what if I'm more of the model? What if I'm more of the model? Like, what do I do? Even though I have 15 years of experience now. 15 years of experience. What do I do? Well, first of all, apparently I'm up all night. But second of all, like, I'm reading economics textbooks. For fun, right? Like, I hope, if anything, it's an inspiration to step up, right? Try a little harder, invest a little more of your time, and get like super serious about it, right? Right? You see what I mean? Hopefully it's an inspiration, because the mythical person was an inspiration to me, and I never had anyone. No one taught me, like, you know, like when I just show you like fibs. Wayne, when is it a reversal and not an you know, extension? Do you know how long that took me to figure out? Like, no joke, like a year. Took me a year to figure that out. I just taught you in a minute. Took me a year to figure that out on my own. You have to realize charts didn't even exist, right? Like, amazing. The old man in a hot bath thing. How does price action work in conjunction with support and resistance to slowly root? You know, that's years of experience. Years, right? So you guys, you got the resources to succeed. But you got to fight. You got to be a fighter. Right? You can do it. Hey, I'm married. I got kids. I travel. I got work. I volunteer to do things. And if you don't sleep through the night, boo-hoo. Yeah. Cool. So anyways, WTI, huh? Now remember, we had this trapped on Friday. Actually, like Thursday, I think we did this. We had it trapped here. We had it trapped down here. Okay. I forget why this lower one, but I remember. Oh, yeah, because I was going for 45. So anyways, we had it trapped here and here on Friday, and Friday after non-farm payrolls, it had spiked, and our plan was to buy the retracement in the roll reversal. And now we're at the extreme target for the week. This 49.49 is the projected target for the week, aggressive. Okay? So now if you were trading technically, you would get out for profit. And you might say, well, Wayne, you can't think that way. It might go up. It might go farther. Yeah. But what's your plan? Right? So that's the projected target for the week. You're there. Hands clean. Ready for supper. Cool. It's just technical analysis. Okay. Let's take a look at our Aussie. Still dropping a little bit, huh? What do you want to do with it? But I like the fact that the real bodies are staying above this area here. Okay. It's bearish, not bullish, but I'm a bull. So I got to be careful. Every time a turtle sticks his neck out to look around, it could get chopped off. Okay? Would you say it's ranging 4 hour? No, I would say, so I drew this area here. This is critical for bulls. Okay. A bull's going to want to take it north. Any lower than that, then it's really not good for a bull. So the fact that we're above the M2 is where bulls would buy for a swing. Okay. So anyone buying it and supporting those real bodies, their plan is this. Okay. So I'm not saying it's going to do that. I'm saying whoever's buying it here, that's their plan. Okay. Well, we know, Hadir, based on the webinar yesterday, there's lots of opportunity to be trading CAD this week. So set up a trade plan. Yeah, monthly swing perhaps. Yeah, absolutely. Maybe. Okay, you got to throw down your monthlies. Tonight we'll be is one tonight. Tonight. Da-da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, this is clearly an important move. So we'll see what happens. But you remember, you are supposed to be setting up monthly swings. And I've told you year after year after year after year that this time of year, this late August to late September, is typically a challenge to your patience. And that you just need to accept that. Okay? You need to accept that it's going to be a test of your patience and you're ready of it. Okay? But if things go well, if you're planning monthly swings, then you'll be in monthly swings. In fact, you'll be in for a couple of months. So you have to be proactively planning those trades. Now, you could do short-term trades too. And I've recommended this many, 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 many times over the years. You should have two accounts, one for day trading and one for position trading. So if you can catch the Aussie yen, I don't know if it's going to go up. I only know the right place. Oops. I only know the right place to try. That's called a plan. We don't know what's going to happen, but all plans are like that. You don't know what's going to happen. You only know where, like what prices to try. So if I bought this, this area here would be a good place to try. Put a stop in a logical place to put a stop. And then shut down your position trading account and go back to your MT4 that you use for day trading. You see what I mean? And it's one of these things where, let's say you had 100 pip stop on this. You either lose 100 pips or you make 1,000 pips. Either way, you collect interest. Yeah. So I told you, like my CAD yen trade, yeah, I've been sitting on it for what, 3 weeks now? And I don't know if I'm going to get knocked out for 100 pip profit or not, but I have locked in 100 pips. My worst case scenario is make 100 pips. But my plan is to make 1,400 pips. This is my plan. And my worst case scenario is to make 100 pips profit. I can't do any worse than that. Now do that 10 times over the course of 10 weeks. It's very plausible, especially when the market turns around, right? What would you do if you had 10 trades that made 1,000 pips? Now, it might take you 8 weeks, right? But a lot of people here are trying to make 300 or 400 pips a month, and they realize it's not a lot of money, so what they do is they jack up the leverage and increase the lot size, which is guaranteed poverty. Yeah, but the thing is, Peter, most people don't even know to try, right? Like, I think most people remember the first time they made 1,000 pips in a month. And then you remember the first time you made 10,000 pips in a month, and it's so much better. But let me tell you, you could probably make 1,000 pips scalping. You probably could. You could have a great month. You're just killing it. Great. I mean, there were times when I traded when the yens fell like 1,000 pips in like a week or a month, 1,000 pips in a month, but it was moving like 200 or 300 pips a day or something. So anyways, you can certainly do it. Okay, you can certainly do it. I've had times where I just crush the yens, but they're moving extraordinarily fast, right? You're scalping and making 200 pips, right? But I mean, just patience and proper technical analysis, just thinking like a real trader. Not these guys on YouTube that are like, look at me, I made $10,000 today, I'm going to jump in my Ferrari, woo, I'm a big man with big sunglasses. You're like, dude, you want to see Forex traders? They're nerdy. They're mathematicians. They're accountants. Right. So, anyways, the way to make the big is to do the big money is to do the fundamental analysis, use technical analysis to identify entry points within the trend, and then slowly build positions in a portfolio, and then let the winners run. And if you try to make a lot of money on a 300 pip month, then the only way to make a lot of money on a 300 pip month is to make every pip worth a lot of money. And that means your losses are, especially as a newer trader with no experience and you don't really get economics and you're not very experienced and you're barely grasping technical analysis, but you want to jack up the value of every pip, I mean, you're going to lose money. You're going to lose pips, and the pips are going to be expensive. Right? Can you imagine how good of a trader you're going to be 10 years from now if you trade every single day and study technical and fundamental analysis? Like, why don't you go big then? Can you wait 10 years? Can you get through medical school before you become a brain surgeon? Can you at least try, right? No, John, no, you don't want to, I don't, they call that scaling. I've always said that scaling's for fishermen. If you got it right, you got it right. Make tons and tons and tons of money, John. It's hard being right. So when you're right, be very, very, very right. Add and add and add and add. And then when you get to obvious end of trend stuff, take your money and run. It's a very, very, very difficult thing to do. But if you recognize you should get out, that's why you're scaling some profit out. You're like, ooh, we're running into a risky area. It might go higher, but this is really, really obviously resistance. Take your money and run. Because you recognize it's resistance, therefore it is resistance. Yeah. Yeah, scaling's for fishermen. And a lot of people do it because they don't have the discipline, or they're not sure in their analysis. You know what I mean? So like, wow, this might be an area to get out, so I'll take some profit off. Dude, you're right. You know what I mean? It's like, no, you got it right. Get paid, man. So anyways, we're looking at pound dollar. You can see this is moving up. We've made a higher high. What's your trade plan? Yeah. You can see this is set up just like oil on Friday. Look at this. Old support hits the target, reverses, makes a higher high. You buy the dip at the roll reversal, long and strong. And this is really simple trading, right? You guys get that? So pound dollar, this high predicts this low, which it did. You see that? You can read it in my book. You can take the training course. You can do whatever you want. Educate yourself. This high predicts that low, and it did it. So if it's textbook, it might not be terribly complicated, right? And then it hit the target, made a higher high. So is it a Fibonacci retracement or is it a reversal? It's a reversal. It made a higher high. There are no higher highs in a downtrend. Do you think it's important that it happened off of the projected low for the month? I mean, you know about it weeks in advance. So clearly, the entire market got up as they were supposed to. So going back to the other question, like John says, you know, John, if you sold here and you hit this area, yeah, you should get up. Okay? Now, I have a little bit of a rule of thumb. This whole green area is an area for bears to take profit. You don't have to take profit at M1, but this lower one, S2, you have to. You have to get up. Law of averages. Just get up. That's your job. You can tell your client, look, I sold it at the top, and I got up at the extreme projected bottom. Squeezed every ounce of blood out of that stone. And maybe it goes a little farther. It doesn't matter, because that was unpredictable. What you're supposed to do is get the predictable trades. If this is your top, that's your bottom. That's predictable. And then you get a higher high off that bottom. You know what's predictable? The higher low, 1, 2, 3 reversal. That's predictable. That's likely. So now we have M2 as the bottom. Guess what's predictable? This is going to this price here. Now, is it? I don't know if it is. But what's predictable is this. I don't know if it is. Okay. I'm only teaching you technical analysis. You know what I mean? Right? It's just technical analysis. It's not my opinion. I don't have an opinion. Okay. Well, I'm trying to make it simple, right? So when you walk away from these webinars, you need to grasp like one small element of what we're talking about, like just basic pivot theory or basic price action theory, or, you know, 1, 2, 3 reversals off support and resistance, whatever it is, a micro piece. And then you should master it. How many hours does it take to master something? Isn't it called the Zulu effect? Right. Yeah, but like you should do that. Right? And you're like, my cousin Zulu, and he doesn't do anything for 10,000 hours. Look, just master that one thing. Okay? Here's what you do. You look for key levels of support and resistance in trending markets. So if it's downtrending, look for the key level support, which might reverse price. If it's trending up, look for levels of resistance that might reverse price. Okay. And then observe whether the series of lower highs and lower lows makes a higher high, or the series of higher highs and higher lows makes a lower low. And look for the reversal. Now, the problem with doing this now is that you're looking for reversals. Okay? And I have a saying for that because it's a dangerous thing. I say, like, I don't like picking bottoms because that strategy stinks. Now, think about it. Right? Picking bottoms, stinky. Yeah. So I'd rather you identify trends and get into the trends. But at least you will be spending time looking and observing and reviewing, and that'll make you a better trader. So like one thing I would ask you to do then, like, so here's an example of trending down into obvious support. And then a higher high, higher low, 1, 2, 3 reversal, okay? So you need to identify the old support and resistance and identify the roll reversal. So like you can use triangles for this, right? Okay? It's not gonna work. Insert, shape, triangle. There you go. What? Have I forgotten how to do this or what? Triangle. What? It's not white, is it? Do I have white triangles? 1, 2, 3. Okay, that worked. All right. So we had a high, a lower low, followed by a higher high. See what I'm getting at here? Let's make this a little bit darker. Okay. And then as soon as you spot one of these, but it has to be at the key reversal support or resistance, then you have to look for the lower low, lower high kind of thing. Okay. Maybe I'll add one more here. Insert, shapes, triangle. So we had a high, a low, lower high. Okay. Lower low, lower high, sell. Lower low, higher high. Whoa-oh. Higher low, off the roll reversal, predicts a higher high. Now this higher high, let's say it goes to here. We don't know where that top is. What's going to happen next? Well, if it's trending, lower low, lower high. So low to here. Okay. Low to here, and then a new high extension, right? And the way you look at that is you can actually draw the fib extension. Okay, see? Down and up. Eventually working our way up to here. See what I'm doing? So, it's just this little one right in here. They hit the support, higher high. If I were you, right, I would ask you, and that would be me, myself, because if I were you, I'd be asking myself to go through and find 100 examples. Print them out. Or at least take a screenshot and save the images in a folder. Okay? Yeah, but it happens all the time. I'm sure I could go through just even my existing charts here and find multiple examples. But print out or at least take screenshots of 100 examples so that you can start mastering that one little blip of information. Okay, and here's the thing, going back to John's answer or question. Do you scale out or get out? Well, if you are an expert now at spotting market reversals, then you know exactly where to get out. And there's no need to scale. And you can say, I've seen this 100 times, or over the time, over a period of time, 10,000 times. And I know the probability of this reversing is extreme. So I'm going to take all my money and I'm going to get out profitably. Okay? You see what I mean? So here's oil. Predictable bottom, higher high, higher low, 1, 2, 3, boom. I got two examples. Boom, boom. Okay. EuroCAD. Check this out. Double bottom on the monthly support pivot. Monthly support 1. Weekly M2. Predict a level of support? Yeah, maybe. Won't it be interesting if it makes a higher high? Okay. Same thing. We did this on Monday. Projected double bottom, potential higher high, right? Didn't we do this when it was up here? I simply said, let's look at the pivot clusters, pretend it's support. Maybe it'll produce a higher high. We don't know. But what if it makes a higher high? What's your trade plan? Because ultimately, this is what happens, right? You start creating trade plans. You're like, oh, man, here's the support. So if it makes a higher high, I think it's going to come back into this roll reversal area. So that's your sweet spot, right? Of course, we know have news coming out for CAD, but I'm just trying to get you into proper habits, right? Wouldn't this be your trade plan? Big wigs, yeah, maybe, depends on the situation. So I've really run the course here. We only did a moderate amount of live technical analysis, but we did a lot of training, I guess you'd call it. Give me one more currency or commodity to cover, and then we'll call it a day. USD Yen, anybody else? Kiwi, USD Yen, Peso. I don't think Peso's done anything, has it? So you've jammed your stop, or it's too late. One of the things. It's come and gone. All right. USD Yen. Lots of USD Yen. Dixie. I have Dixie on all my charts, or most of my charts. Like, here's gold, for example. And there's my Dixie. Looks like Dixie's falling on the hourly chart. On the 4-hour chart. And on the daily. Hey, did Karsten's retire? From the Bank of Mexico? I thought that was coming up. It's just something I haven't been paying attention to. MRC says, when can we expect dollar strength again? Why don't you identify levels of support? And then watch those areas of support, looking for reversal patterns. Is that right, Nuno? So I guess a lot of USD Yen. All right, fine, great. To me, it's not a great trade, but fine. Let's get into it. Yeah. Are we at support? Well, let's identify support. We have price action support. And we have pivot support. Let's see. This is just weekly, huh? Let's change this template and throw down monthlies as well. Okay. So we got support here. Okay. I guess we got to get up through all of this. There's a lot going on here. So let me connect this bottom with this sort of top here. We got to get through all of that. All of that's resistance. Okay, and you know a bear is getting ready to sell this soon, probably up here. Okay, fine. But this is gorgeous, right? So I will remove this top one. I just want to point all that resistance out. So we got this beautiful bottom. So I think what needs to happen is we need a double bottom higher high. Okay. And it looks like it's going to get set up in the next few hours to make the low. So meaning it needs to go up. So let's follow this. It's going to go up and hit resistance. It's going to hit the pivot cluster, and it's going to hit the 55. Okay, what will the oscillator look like at that time? If it goes up to that pivot cluster and the 55 holds as a dynamic level of resistance, what will happen to the oscillator? Yeah, it should roll over. Okay. If it doesn't, then you don't trade. It doesn't matter. Okay. But the 55 is supposed to hold. Now, we may not be in a ranging market, so you got to be careful. But let's just say it does hold. What does the 55 predict? Double bottom. Cool. Back at support. So now let's say this is a double bottom of a double bottom. Okay? It's just an hourly chart, but let's just say it's a double bottom of a double bottom. Great. So what will happen now when we're testing the support and the support holds? What will the oscillator look like? Probably down here again, right? And if we stop making lower lows, it's going to kick up too. And this will take 12 hours. Cool. But we want to be long this for the long term, meaning more than a couple of hours, hopefully a few days or a week, maybe a month. We don't know, right? So what would we want the four-hour chart to look like now? We want the 4 hour to say this is a bottom. So I'm going to switch now to the 4 hour. Look at the oscillator. The oscillator says this is a bottom on a monthly pivot. Right? Monthly S1 predicts monthly R1, which is also a weekly pivot cluster. So if we are able to grab a little double bottom on the hourly chart, which is just a little one or two candles here, then the plan should be to take us here by the end of September. We should be there at least, if that comes together. So on this chart, are you at support or are you at support, yes or no? Yes. Is it oversold? Yes. Drop into a smaller time frame. Look for technical opportunities. Would you call that a higher high? Six-one-eight predicts 1382, which brings us back to a roll reversal. Okay. If that happens, you plan that now and you observe all that happening, you probably won't lose a lot of money. If the market actually ends up doing that, you'll probably make more money than you potentially risk losing. Namaste. Thank you for being a client to Traders Way. We appreciate you. I appreciate you. And I'm here to tell you every day it's worth the effort. But I don't know, I want you to know you need to fight for it. There's someone else trying harder than you right now. So what are you going to do? Right? Since I haven't slept, I haven't been on Forex.Today this morning. Something tells me that 75 of you have not posted a trade plan for the day. So what am I supposed to do? How do I make you better if you don't want to even do a simple amount of work? Like post one trade plan. How are you going to improve? When is this magically just going to trickle out of the sky? Are you going to get better through osmosis? Like, right? It's a skill. You got to practice. You got to work hard. Right on. Thank you, Polly. So, if you're just unsure of how to post a trade plan or unsure of technical or fundamental analysis, you're just not ready, then at least spend some time on Paul's trades, because he did six. Review his, leave him some comments and some feedback. Okay? Thank you, Paul. All right. Well, then I will suspend that guy. But I need to see some trade plans. Like, some guy's posting trade plans and somebody's complaining about it. What do you care if he has a signal service? He's posting trade plans. But anyways, I'll address that. Post some trade plans. Not for me, for you, for the community, and other people, if you can, leave people that are posting trade plans some feedback. For yourself, think about it. What does their chart say? What do you agree with? What do you disagree with? What are you concerned about? What did they miss? What did you like? Okay? Yeah, Marina is great. Forex.Today, Emilio. Anyone can post. You just drag and drop. Cool. So, gotta go, guys. Peace on earth. May the pips be with you. May your profits be above average. I hope to see you here tomorrow. Okay? Oh, take care, Percy. Remember, open a demo account at least at TradersWay, okay? Thank you.